Marc of Horror here with Hugsy and our guest star Viola, and we're here to talk about April's Horror Pack. But first I thought I'd say a few words about March's Horror Pack. March's Horror Pack was the pyramid, which I had seen in the movie theater, but hadn't remembered particularly well, so I went for a rewatch, and it was actually pretty good. It was pretty entertaining. I enjoyed the shots of Egypt and the different take on a pyramid. And then I watched Army of Frankenstein's from Scream Factory, which was a little juvenile, but it was pretty entertaining. It had some fresh ideas. It had quite a mix of fantasy with horror, and was kind of goofy, but goofy in a fun way. And then I watched Chillerama, which is a series of stories based around a drive-in movie theater, and some of the details are great, and I really liked that one of the segments was called The Diary of Anne Frankenstein. I thought that was funny. Unfortunately, it's depressingly juvenile, and it has a lot of jokes. It's very comedic, and I didn't laugh once, so I may be an old fuddy-duddy. I did not find Chillerama to be particularly funny. It was, you know, kind of shrug your shoulders at each one of the jokes. It was not bad. It was just not particularly good. But if I thought that Chillerama was depressingly juvenile, She Kills was really, really juvenile. And not in a good way. Again, no laughs, just groaningly bad. I close my eyes when I think of the film. So I love Horror Pack, and I love the selections that they pick out, and they usually pick out a balanced selection. They usually try and include something that's classic and something that's comedy and so on and so forth. Last month turned out to be not so good. Hugsy, you need to go away so I can open the package. Okay, you can sit here next to Viola. But there's no telling what we're going to find in April's box. And as usual, Horror Pack packs it inside a protective envelope inside the box that they sent. First title they sent is Way of the Wicked, starring Emily Tennant, Vinnie Jones, Jake Croker, and Christian Slater. Christian Slater stars with Vinnie Jones in this heart-stopping supernatural thriller. After a series of inexplicable murders sweeps a small, isolated community, Father Henry goes to a local police detective, Vinnie Jones, with a theory on why the murders are occurring. The two learn that a troubled teen with a dark past has recently moved to town and has set his sights on the cop's beautiful young daughter. Father Henry, who turns out to have secrets of his own, finds himself pitted against a demonic force more diabolically evil and twisted than any of them could have imagined. So I've not seen this one. I'm looking forward to watching that. Basically, if it's a horror movie I haven't seen, I'm always looking forward to it. Cabin Fever. Patient Zero. Terror is contagious.
Hello. They're all sick. There's blood everywhere.
We are on the verge of a global pandemic.
You're not just a carrier. You're a possible cure.
You can't just keep experimenting on me.
You are patient zero.
Getting married tomorrow.
One last night of freedom. A chartered trip to a deserted tropical island.
Here.
What happened?
Penny thinks she saw something.
Look at this.
Oh, Jesus. Baby, I told you to put on sunscreen.
I think Manny's sick.
Listen, Penny needs help now. There was a structure on the north side of the island. We're gonna go. We'll be back soon.
Doesn't look locked to me.
Hello?
We have a medical situation.
What the hell is this place?
Man! We gotta get off this island!
Blind mice.
We have no way of containing.
A group of friends planned the perfect vacation in the Caribbean, but when they head ashore to explore a remote island, their ultimate bachelor weekend devolves into their worst nightmare. After an ill-fated swim in contaminated water, they stumble upon a seemingly abandoned research facility where a deadly, flesh-eating virus has been unleashed. The only people left alive are a handful of secretive medical personnel and patient zero, Sean Astin, the lone person who's been exposed to the disease and shows no symptoms. Can they find a way to survive and escape, or will a virus consume them all in a bloodbath of chaos and carnage? I have seen Cabin Fever Patient Zero before. I really love Eli Roth's first Cabin Fever, and I didn't care for the sequels, but I will give this one another shot, and I will let you know next month whether I appreciated it more. Of course it's Easter time, so we have Rotten Tail.
No one in or out until Project MR is complete.
I don't have any projects called MR.
I can't really talk about it because it's top secret.
Find out how to make more of these things ASAP.
Yes, sir.
Hey, how are you?
You're gonna need to send help.
Send everyone.
It's not Peter anymore.
It's Rotten Tail now.
I am a rabbit man. I mean, not like a rabbit man, but a rabbit man.
There is no such thing as a bunny man.
Are you ready to see the Easter Bunny, kids?
Yeah!
Robert, bring me his brains!
Man, it's still King of Jungle!
And I'm King Kong, bitch!
Woo! Goddamn! Where's his head? You ever seen that before? Goddamn, I've never seen that before!
Well, that Woo! Is one crazy story.
Look at that! It's still blood coming out! God damn!
So, see how they theme it? And this is the HorrorPack Limited Edition Blu-ray, Rotten Tail, Hippity Hoppity Homicide. Rotten Tail tells the bizarre tale of young Peter Cotton, who grew up in the town of Easter Falls and loves rabbits. As you can't tell, but behind the camera, my wife is rolling her eyes. Peter's science project on rabbit breeding is ruined when the school bullies beat up his rabbit. Years later, the kind but still shy Dr. Cotton works steadily and gently with his rabbits to cure human infertility. Unbeknownst to Peter, the military is this work, developing fierce soldiers with strength far exceeding a human of their size, because we all know that rabbits are known for their strength. And with Peter's fertility serum, the ability to breed in the field. Sorry. Peter discovers the true nature of the experiment and attempts to stop it. But in an accident of poetic justice, a bite from an experimental mutant rabbit combines with Peter's own serum to transform him into the evil Rotten Tail. Well, I've definitely not seen this. Easter has passed, but I'm definitely going to give this a look. And that leaves... Don't Knock Twice, and comes with a slipcover.
When I was a kid, there was this strange old woman. People started saying she was a witch. If you knocked on her door, she would come and get you.
Hi, Chloe.
I know that your recent relationship with your daughter hasn't been easy.
She believes that witches are conspiring to feed her to a demon.
Be careful, Jess. There's a darkness around her.
Did you do this?
I thought I was safe here.
Chloe? Who are you?
She opens a doorway between hell so she can devour the innocent. She's coming for me next.
What's gonna happen to you?
Don't Knock Twice, starring Katie Sackhoff and Lucy Boynton. Pray she doesn't answer. When troubled teen Chloe defies a local legend's warning and knocks at the door of a long, abandoned house, she unleashes a horror beyond her darkest nightmares, the vengeance of a relentless, child-stealing witch. With nowhere else to turn, Chloe heads for the country home of her estranged mother, Jess, a recovering addict who is desperate to reconnect with her daughter. Now, mother and daughter must once again learn to trust each other if they have any hope of surviving the relentless force shadowing Chloe. A well-crafted thriller that's rooted in the real world but dipping its toes into a Brothers Grimm fairy tale. Don't Knock Twice is the wellspring of your next nightmare. This one I have seen. I don't believe I have it on Blu-ray, so that'll be nice. I'll replace my DVD. And this one is actually a pretty good one. So all in all, I think we got a good selection this month to work through. Way of the Wicked, Cabin Fever Patient Zero, and Rotten Tail, and Don't Knock Twice. Anyway, please click like, subscribe, or even comment below on the selection that they've sent. Thank you.